But in addition to being an entrepreneur, open up bars and stuff, you're also in a new film franchise. Well, the franchise isn't new. You're new to it. He's playing the Falcon in the upcoming film, Captain America, The Winter Soldier. It's a great
Look at my arms,
franchise.
Dude. Look at my arms, man. 225. That's man weight. 225, 15 reps.
That was airbrushing.
Nah, that's all me. This is how you know it's not airbrush. So when we were shooting, I always had on these shirts, so I got like a farmer's tan.
Yeah.
And if you look at the poster, you can still see
Bring
my
farmer's tan. Bring that poster up
again. Look at my farmer's tan, right?
You got a farmer's
tan. That's how you know, Kim. One side of my arm is like Wesley Snipes. The other side is like Will Smith. So it's like it's two is all different right up in here. That's how you know it's real.
That's good stuff, man. You excited to be part of that? I mean, that's a big deal.
I am, man. It's a monumental moment in my career. When I first started acting, I said I want to do a Western, preferably with Clint Eastwood, and I want to be a superhero.
Yeah.
And when Marvel gave me the opportunity to bring this character to life, I mean, I was so emotional and just overjoyed at the opportunity of being a part of not only a franchise like that, but a studio like that.
Were you a comic kid growing up?
No, I was a baseball kid. I was everything. I was a sports kid. I mean, I played sports through and through. I was an outdoors kid. My parents had a rule. You don't come inside unless you have to use the bathroom or the streetlights on.
Right.
That's the rule. Other than that, you outside.
Yes.
You know what I mean? So I was never into comic books. I was never that kid.
So then that must have been even an even more interesting sort of switch when you get into a franchise like
Definitely.
This.
Definitely. My brother, you know, my brother was really into comic books growing up. He's 15 years older than me. So when I got the role, I called him and he was like, oh, in 1963, blah, 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 blah. You know, because comic book heads
They're
know their
nerds,
history.
Man, that's
man.
What I'm trying to tell you. They are going to come
history.
To your movie with like a book, an almanac, a
already,
notepad. They're going to
have already,
this stuff.
Already. Yeah. It's crazy how much they know. And if you deter from that, it's like, oh, well, that's not authentic. It's like, you know, that's not real.
Right.
Like, it's made
real
up
people.
So we can change it, you know? No, that's not right. Nah, he's real. All right.
Speaking of heroes in comics, Michael B. Jordan. Is also, you know, rumored at least. We don't know for sure.
No. He's there.
He's going to be cast as Johnny Storm in Fantastic Four.
Yeah.
Now, what's interesting is some people are saying, well, the character doesn't correspond to his skin color. In other words, he's not what we think that character's supposed to look like.
Right.
Is it hard to get past that where audiences can't see black people doing other things, other characters?
Well, Michael B. Jordan is a very good friend of mine. Yeah. I've known him since he was a teenager. And I think I'm so happy for more than anybody else for him to be getting the accolades he's getting because he deserves them. Yeah. If you watch him all the way back, if you watch him all the way back to everything he's done, he killed Friday Night Lights, he killed The Wire, he killed Fruit, everything he's done. So he deserves it. He's the next generation.
Yeah.
And I think with these types of movies, everything else aside, you need a good actor.
Yeah.
And Michael B. Jordan is a good actor. Black or white. So what you have to realize is, and go back and forth and just say, Superman can't fly. Batman ain't real.
Right.
The Human Torch don't really set himself on fire and fly around the room. So he can look like whatever they want him to look like.
Yeah.
You just have to allow yourself to see him that way. And if you can't do that, that says something about you.
Are audiences there yet, though? Because the bottom line is they got to come to the audience and watch it.
Well, I think as an audience member, if you can't do that, you need to look at yourself.
Yeah.
Because there's something going on with you that you might need some help with.